Greetings again, two-stroke fans. Now, we're getting straight into it. Time to measure up, time to play. Because we're going to use the information that I've given you so far through the course of these videos for some useful purpose. And that will be is examining the pipe you've got or the pipe you plan to have and your engine to find out if the pipe is working on the engine that it's attached to. And to do that, we need to cover two things: port timings, chamber lengths, and angles. Now, the port timings can be measured using a number of formula to extrapolate the port timings from the distances of the port to the top of the cylinder, etc., etc. The chamber lengths and such are a little bit more difficult to measure when it's actually assembled. It's easy enough to make them and make the angles and then know where everything is. But once it's actually assembled and welded together, it's a little bit harder to measure the straight line length between one end of a cone and the other, shown vertically here, the straight line length. And the reason we need to know the straight line length of all of these exactly is because we need to be able to calculate the tuned lengths. I showed that in earlier videos, and this video assumes that you have watched the previous videos. We've covered the timings and what we're working with there, and the diffuser cone and the baffle cone. Now, the baffle cone mean point of reflection is not calculated the same way as the point of the creation of our expansion wave from the diffuser, and I will get into that. But what I'm talking about now is actually measuring the cones. So I've added a little bit into that other tuned length program as well, a couple of formulas for taking the maximum minimum diameters of the pipe, measuring along the outside edge to get the center line, and also to derive the angle of it, because it's a little bit hard to actually measure the angles accurately on the pipes. And you may have a diffuser with a number of diffuser cones of increasing angles down the diffuser. As to what that explicitly does, go back to earlier videos, but essentially as the wave loses its energy down the length of the angle, we increase the angle, and thus we get a little bit more boost of a greater expansion at lower energy. So we basically just get a fatter diffuser wave or expansion wave and a bit longer suction. And that can be important in most engines, and in particular in relationship to the type of intake timing we have. Now, keep in mind with timings into an analogy to a four-stroke is the inlet valve is the transfer and the exhaust valve is the exhaust, okay? The inlet system on the port, reed or rotary disc intake is the inlet timing for the crankcase. Just making that point. Now, what we're going to be measuring for is the distances of the diffuser and the baffle cone from the exhaust to get our timing there. And we're also going to be measuring the distances from the diffuser to the baffle cone, because that is linked. And I'll show you the reason why that is, that distance is linked. And that's to ensure the proper phasing of the two waves. Because remember, the expansion wave is the opposite phase to the compression wave coming off the reflection. Going back to an earlier video with an example, this is just a graphical representation, not what the wave looks like, of the expansion wave with a less, with a lower pressure, compression wave reflecting back off the baffle cone. And as you can see, if this leading edge of this compression wave overlaps the expansion wave, or this wave in its entirety overlaps the expansion wave, called a superposition of the, both the waves, they will cancel each other out. Whereas a superposition of two compression waves will have a doubling effect only for the moment of superposition until the waves continue after. You can observe that if you drop two stones into a pond and you'll see the ripples meet each other and then pass each other. But at the moment they meet each other, there is a higher peak in the wave, and then they appear to continue past each other. And that superposition, if that superpositioning occurs at the moment that our timing relies on the wave, we're going to get either a drop or a boost. In this case, we're going to get a drop if the phasing is not sufficient distance away. So that's why this has to be a sufficient distance away from this. And I think that will do it for the day. And if anybody would like me to show you the measurements and the formulas that I used for resolving this stuff, for being able to measure up your cone and getting the lengths of it, I can show you that. Hit the comments section if you need it. If not, there's no real point in showing it, but you can find those yourself. They're trigonometry. Anyway, that will do it for today. Okay, bye now.